Thank you very much and a very good morning to all of you. Yes, my name is Evelyn Nguleka. As Nancy said, actually becoming the president of the World Farm Organization has disturbed my farming activities quite a lot because I have to be in a lot of places at a lot of times, and I can't locate the Secretary General. He's right here, Mr. Marco Mazzano, from Italy. He makes sure that every month I'm out of my farm. Seems to be his preoccupation. And I should say that I am grateful that I've been given more privileges than a lot of farmers have received. To be able, not just to be able to represent them, but in the process I've been able to learn quite a lot. And I'm hoping that at the end of my term as president of the World Farm Organization, and by the way, I'm also the president of our local farmers organization, the Zambia National Farmers Union. So I'm not only doing the international battles, I have to fight with my local government to make sure that the farmer's voice is not only heard, but the farmer's livelihood is changed. And when I spoke to Nancy this morning, yes, I grew up with my grandma. And one of the things that I appreciate is that she made sure that I went to school, and that makes a very big difference. I could be able to read and write and be able to have a better life than she did. And that is very, very important. And of course, that is where most of you come in. There are a lot of people that we can be able to help. First and foremost, making sure that they have the right knowledge, making sure that they are exposed in the right direction. I'd also like to thank Mariana. I met Mariana last year at the Zambia National Farmers Union. So at least if you need clarification, she will explain to you that I'm not only busy in the plains and everywhere on the platforms, I'm very busy at home also. She visited our farmers' organization, which is quite a very big organization in the country, and we are working with government to make sure that Zambia is not on the radar for wrong reasons, but Zambia is on the radar to make sure that it's a safe place, we have enough food for our people, and our children are growing better. And that's a model that we all want. Each and every country should be proud to do that. And I am happy that I am contributing to that. One more thing that I have to tell you is, I've had to have the thoughts put on paper, because sometimes I'm asked to make a recollection of what I'd said and I can't remember. So you will have to excuse me, I'll read. So that next time, maybe next year when you want to make a quote, then I'll just have to go through my file and I'll know exactly what I said at which forum. Otherwise, if it just comes from my head, I'll probably refuse if it didn't come from me. So, Your Excellencies, I had a number of ministers, I think dignitaries who are here today. I'm very happy that you are able to be with us. If there are any farmers in our midst, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm very happy to see already that we have people in the media who make sure that what we say and what we do gets out there. Without them, what we are doing remains behind these walls. So I'm very passionate about people in the media because they help us disseminate the information. And for some of you, you might be wondering, why a farmer? I mean, trade is not only about food. But I believe, for me, I think it's a very big milestone to realize that in a platform, a very important platform like yours, you choose to have a farmer as a keynote speaker. And this gives us an opportunity as farmers to showcase to you that what we do is not only put food on your table. And if, for some of the people who try to think a little bit outside the box, they think, ah, okay, it's not just food, but also the clothing, because they do the cotton. But it's more than that. Farmers contribute to a number of things that we do not account for. A lot of jobs emanate from the fact that there is a farmer behind the scene. A lot of industries, a lot of shipping that we're talking about will not go ahead if the farmer does not do his work. So it is important for me and for all the farmers, small, medium and large, from all over the world that contribute to our livelihood. And I would like to say thank you very much for recognizing our position and for recognizing what we do. So I'm very grateful to the Global Donor Platform for this invitation to be here today and address this plenary on behalf of the World Farmers Organization. The World Farmers Organization is an international member-based organization whose mandate is to bring together farmers organizations and agricultural cooperatives from all over the world. And that is why I'm called Flying Farmer. It represents the global farming community, including small and the large farmers. The World Farmer Organization has 80 members currently, and we are in 50 countries from all over the region. So from the north to the south. Among the key priorities of the World Farm Organization is to support the process of strengthening and improving their position within the food supply chain so as to facilitate better management and extreme price volatility, improve the market returns, and timely access to market information at local and international levels. The World Farmers Organization's work covers all agriculture-related thematic areas, and these include food security, climate change, the value chain, innovation, trade that we are discussing today, livestock, women, and I'm a typical example of a woman, contract farming, rural finance, the youth. Unfortunately, I'm no longer a youth, though I look like one. Research and extension services. The World Farmers encourages farmers' involvement in sustainable rural development, in the protection of the environment, and in other emerging challenges, such as access to finance, in the generational renewal, and in the gender equality. We believe that women and men should have an equal and possibly strong voice. Either you're a man or a woman, if you have something to say, you should be heard. As trade is the central asset for the global farming community, the World Farmers Organization made sure that one of our milestones was to have a policy on trade. This was unveiled in April 2013, and it was presented to the World Trade Organization Ministerial Conference in Bali, Indonesia, in December 2013. So we recognize as farmers that trade is necessary. And I'm sure if you need more details about our policy, the Secretary General is here and will be able to give you all the information on that. The policy recognizes that trade helps to even out demand and supply. It helps us to bring out the imbalances that's contributing to food security and promotes resource use to efficient and economic growth. It is also a way of providing farmers with increased market opportunity and thereby helps to improve incomes and the prosperity of rural communities. This is something that I say normally to our government. As much as everybody knows me in Zambia, as the president of the Zambia National Farmers Union, and also now in a number of your countries where you're coming from, as the president of the World Farmers Organization, even if I got sick today, I mean, just yesterday I was with one of the board members of the World Farmers Organization, is a Swiss farmer. He's our treasurer, actually, so maybe for a very good reason, he comes from Switzerland. If I got sick here today, I'm not going to be exempted from paying the bill because I'm a farmer. I still have to pay the bills. I still have to pay the bills for my children to go to school. I still have to pay the bills to wear my clothes. And therefore, trade cannot be isolated from what we do. And unfortunately, when discussions are being made about farmers, we are not thinking about that, that the farmer also needs an income in their pockets. So it's not only the price of the food that we put on the table, but what is the income that is going to the farmer, for the farmer to be able to continue with their livelihoods. Farmers must be at the center of the global and rural agriculture economy. They are called to produce high quality food for a growth world that is the population is growing into. To be able to produce sustainably and also to make sure that the environment is safe. In this perspective, it is our vision that representatives of farmers' organizations be fully consulted in the decisions to open trade negotiations involving agriculture, including those at bilateral and multinational levels. Being an organization that operates at a global level, the World Farmers Organization recognizes partnerships as a key element to us farmers to succeed in our mandate of feeding the planet. We cannot not do this alone. With this in mind, we appreciate very much the partnership with the actors of the Global Donor Platform, and I am glad that I'm here today, as we are confident that the Donor Platform members would support the farming community, particularly in developing countries, in many ways. At a political level, international donors may support national governments in the formulation of policies that grant farmers the opportunity to extend their market access with incentives to investments at farm level, or to facilitate proper access to finance and liquidity that farmers can use to improve their efficiency and hence the productivity of their farms. As economic, social players and political situations may vary from country to country, even within the same region, it is very important that farmers, through their representatives, like organizations or cooperatives, are fully involved in the formulation of such policies at national and global level. Being agriculture as an economic actor, not only when farmers are compensated with proper income for their work, a virtuous cycle can be established with positive effects for the overall society. Furthermore, profitability ensures that farmers remain a viable, sustainable career option for the young people, and it will boost the transition between generations. When I sit in meetings with a lot of farmers, half the time I'm the youngest. And that is something that we have to start thinking about. The young people need to be interested, and then shouldn't be able to do it because they are feeling pity for the world, but they should be able to make an income out of it. So profitability is needed for agriculture to be able to compete with alternative employment opportunities in the city and to make further investment in the social and environmental pillars of sustainability. In this perspective, farmers require reasonable farm gate prices, as well as innovative techniques to how low to bring down the production cost at the farm level. In a food supply chain where farmers are classed between the dealers and the input providers, farmers are often price takers with little bargaining power, especially from Asia and Africa, where even negotiation is very, very difficult. As a responsible agripreneur, farmers constantly strive to achieve ever greater efficiencies. An effective and efficient use of inputs leads to increased productivity and reduced environmental impacts. And this is what we pledged at the COP21. We are willing to produce more food, and we will take in account that we do it in a manner that will not harm the environment. We are aware of that. We live in this planet as much as everybody else. Moreover, farmers have an inner link with the natural resources and a deeper knowledge of the natural factors and values of agriculture products, which they always are ready to mainstream with decision-making processes on policies focused on health. In this context, for instance, research plays a critical role whose results could be improved by farmers who could be involved in the formulation and implementation. Farmers produce a wide variety of food for the whole year consumption. This variety provides a balanced diet with high nutritional values. We produce vegetables, fruits, grains, and animal products, and is key to end all forms of malnutrition and ensure healthy lives for all. In this sense, governments could count on farmers as first-hand experience in the formulation and implementation of policies on food and nutrition. At a farm level, farmers, through their organizations, should be supported to access innovation, to reduce the production costs and raise productivity. Innovation may include mechanization at farm level, but also building brands for agriculture products or attract packaging to better place their products on the market or implementation of market practices for better selling their products. Encouraging trade is essential for the farmers to overcome the many challenges that are constantly in our lives. One of these is due to the fact that the world's population is increasing, but our resources of land and water are finite, and they are under threat at the moment. And I'm glad that the Vice President mentioned that one time it was the price of fuel that brought the crisis, and now we're dealing with availability of water. And it is already happening. In a lot of places, water has become a very big challenge and a constraint on how farmers are able to produce food. In some parts of the countries of the world, it's too much water. In some parts of the world, it is completely dry, and we need to find a balance for it. Unfortunately, God is not making any more adjustments to land and water. We have to deal with what we have. Moreover, as farmers, we are facing more extreme climate change and long-term shifts in the growing conditions due to climate change. Price volatility is also a stressing challenge that more and more affects the trade conditions for farmers in the agriculture markets. Trade helps to even out the demand and supply imbalances, thus contributing to food security. It is also a way of providing farmers with increased market opportunities and so helps to improve our incomes and the prosperity of the rural communities. Market access is improved also when infrastructure are efficient enough to facilitate product transportation and consequent food losses that happen in a number of places where infrastructure is not well developed. Moreover, farmers need support to improve their practices at farm level, which include from storage, cleaning, packaging their products, and even processing, as more value-added values will stay in the country and the more farmers will obtain a better return for what they have produced. Dear colleagues, almost all farmers in the world are small enterprises, and all of them will need to increase production significantly if future demand for food is to be met. However, the challenges we face are increasing. In this context, international organizations should assist the development of stronger local networks through extension services, which in a number of times do not exist from our local governments, training, research and development, implementation of farmers' market capacity, and by providing and implementing competition policies which allow strong farmer-owned organizations, including cooperatives and collective market initiatives, to operate efficiently. On our side, as farmers, we stand ready to work to strengthen our organization structures. Farmers should be encouraged to be in groups as farmer-owned organizations, including cooperatives, so that we can strengthen collective market incentives. Colleagues, we as farmers believe that partnership is the first element to make the agriculture sector successful as well as sustainable for all. In this view, we really need the support of all of you, and it is very important to me. And we hope that in the future we could strengthen even more our collaboration and make together the right steps in the direction of a flourishing and efficient trade environment for farmers, for the whole global community. And as I end my address today, I would like to bring to your attention that without cooperation from you, the donors, partners, stakeholders seated here, we will not be able to achieve this as farmers. Your influence is very, very important. And I believe that farmers are not going to be able to do this without your help. We need each other, and we have to go ahead. And also, it is important to bring to your attention what would have happened to this farmer if there was not collaboration and partnerships from people like yourselves. Would I have been standing here today in Switzerland? Would I have been speaking on behalf of the many millions of farmers all over the world? And the answer is no. And what I'd love to leave with you is, what are you doing to make sure that the next vulnerable farmer, the next vulnerable person gets your help and be able to contribute to a global platform that we live in? And I hope that Nancy will be able to tackle that and be able to bring out from you what is it that you are ready to do as partners to make sure that there's not only one flying farmer, but there will be much more than this one Evelyn Nguleka. So thank you very much, and I wish you all the best.